Never did I expect to see a Japanese movie that looks exactly like some sort of Club Penguin fan animation, but, well, here we are. Looking at the design of the penguins here, you'll immediately recognize the resemblance to the one seen in the immensely popular children's online multiplayer game, but there's a catch. This movie came out in 1985. Yeah, that's around 20 years before Club Penguin even released to the public, but they just feel so similar and it's hard to believe how old this movie is. Before we get into Penguin's memory, it'd probably be best to go into the brief background and inspiration. Our incredible story begins with beer. Not exactly what I expected at all, but cool. A very popular Japanese brewing company group in the 1980s was Suntory, and they made Suntory beer. There were several animated commercials centering around this well-known beer, which featured brightly colored penguins who all had their own clothes and styles. They would be singing, enjoying themselves on the beach, and most importantly, drinking beer. These commercials also played some catchy Japanese songs that really urged people to buy this beer, plus the visuals were so pleasing to the eye, and when you have all these nice penguins, how can you not buy this beer? And now that you know that small bit of history, it's finally time to go into the Club Penguin anime movie, Penguin's Memory. Looking at the poster will reveal many different penguins of varying colors and shapes, having their own items and personalities. The main star of this movie is a guy named Mike, who we see for the very first time fighting in the Vietnam War. You heard that right. Club Penguin meets beer meets Vietnam War. All these things seem like they wouldn't go together at all, but we'll be seeing today if the movie actually does anything right, and if it's worth a watch. Here's the plot. Mike is a penguin soldier who returns home after being injured during combat. Estranged from his family and friends, he leaves his hometown and starts to roam adrift through the country. Right from the opening scenes, it's easy to tell that this is no comedy. Despite it involving cute, happy penguins as every single character, this dives into some really heavy stuff. Club Penguin may have seriously gotten inspiration from this movie, particularly with the designs because they look so much like the same, but still, Club Penguin made everything cheerful, and if you go into this thinking it'll be as happy, you're gonna get something much darker. Anyway, all these penguins are shooting guns and fighting in this war, trying to do whatever it takes to eliminate the bad guys and get out alive. We then focus on three different penguins, Mike, Al, and Tom, who talk about their life back home and what they'll be doing when they get out of the war. Some deep words are said here, which I won't go over entirely for now, but if you do end up watching this movie, you'll be pleasantly surprised. Despite the powerful bond that these three heroes form, it's sadly cut short as both Al and Tom meet their unfortunate death. Mike is the only one that ends up getting out alive, and he returns to his hometown. What he brings with him as a reminder is a harmonica that one of his friends played in the war. When he finally gets to his hometown, he's treated as a hero, but he doesn't like that and seems to have post-traumatic stress disorder immediately after the return, mostly because he's faced so much prior to the start of the movie and he lost the only friends he made along the way. Okay, first impressions before we get further into the plot. Honestly, yeah, there are the funny similarities to Club Penguin that can't be ignored, like literally every character's design. But still, this is a serious story. After watching the war scenes at the beginning, I really didn't know whether to laugh or to be confused or to really empathize with Mike as a character. Just seeing these penguins in such a serious and real-life situation is so weird, but I got used to it pretty quickly. I also have to say that the style at this point in Penguin's memory has been absolutely incredible. There's a certain aesthetic that 80s Japanese animated movies go for, and oh boy, this is seriously more pleasing on the eyes than you think. So yeah, I first thought at this point it would be an interesting ride, plus the amazing visuals would help me get by. Mike feels completely lost being around his family, and he doesn't know what to do with his life. He starts going on a journey. Where's his destination, you may ask? Well, he doesn't really have a main idea at first. It's more like wandering for silence and peace. Again, not something you expect from a story with these cute penguin characters, but once you get past that, this movie really is something special. The awesome aesthetic appeal of Penguin's Memory continues as Mike goes on his long aimless journey, eventually getting into a fight but is beaten up pretty badly after. He ends up in Lake City, Florida, and things get super upbeat out of nowhere. A brand new, very significant character is introduced, who sings happily as we see nature and the world go round, along with happy kids who join in on the fun. Let's go! Now what exactly is all this? I was so confused when I first saw it because we got to see Mike walking around depressed and then the cut to all this bright stuff was so sudden. The environment gets immediately darker when the kid's soccer ball bounces on over to Mike, showcasing his serious emotions. Eventually, we find out that this new character is named Jill and she will soon become the love interest for the film. But something cool happens next. Mike finds himself in a library, and there's a little poster that said, "The librarian is needed!" Okay, this is actually a help wanted sign, and that's not how help wanted signs work at all, it's just weird. But the company who worked on this film probably didn't completely understand English, so I'm gonna give this a pass. Now because Mike enjoys reading poetry, and this was established earlier in the movie, he takes the job of librarian. This is also really nice, because ever since he left his hometown, he's been in search of complete peace and silence. I mean, honestly, what more can you want after going through such a devastating war? The silence is exactly what goes on in a library, so you actually kind of feel good for him when he gets the job. Things are finally settling down as Mike finds peace within himself and figures out what he wants to do next. He also has two separate destinations that he wants to visit for relaxation, so he plans out how he can take the journey to each place. Now, because I really don't want to spoil the entire movie for you, I'll briefly mention some of the upcoming events. Mike finds love with Jill and it becomes a large part of the film, but at the same time he has to deal with the drama surrounding it, which is more entertaining to watch than you think. The love interest Jill has a dream to be a singer, and she comes across an opportunity to become famous that may or may not jeopardize the love between these penguins. A lot more happens, especially with a bird who I really won't get into because that stuff can get extremely sad, but yeah. Penguin's Memory is most certainly not what you expect in any way. On the surface, it's just a penguin fighting in a war and then moving on while trying to be at peace and not take life for granted. But when you sit down to watch the entire thing, it really gets deep. You might be wondering, how would I rate this movie? Well, it was much better than I expected. For a Japanese film all about promoting a type of beer, it was amazing as a standalone story. It actually doesn't feel like it's an advertisement, probably because there isn't even a large emphasis on beer throughout the story. Also, I just have to mention the aesthetic again in Penguin's Memory. It was just so nice and creative. I would initially give this a 7 out of 10 overall, but the storyline with Mike's bird is just too good that I have to bump it up to a 7.5 out of 10. And seriously, you guys, that ending, I was actually really invested in the story by that point. Mike's journey is undoubtedly worth a watch, just don't expect it to be a wacky, cute penguin adventure. Now, let's go over some of the similarities to Club Penguin. It really still makes no sense how this came out in 1985, but the game released 20 years later. I really do think that the team behind Club Penguin got some sort of inspiration from this movie. Obviously, the designs of the characters are very much like the penguin seen online. They come in a wide variety of colors like blue, red, and black, just like the colors that can be bought in the gift shop. Many of the penguins here will be wearing hats and other pieces of clothing that look like they came straight out of Club Penguin 2. This beard is literally just the Santa's beard from Club Penguin. I remember getting that when I was really young, and I loved this item. While the designs are the most clear similarity to CP, there's also this part of the movie that has the same feel and music to the pizza parlor.
そうなの。だから歌なんて教えるのもよして花嫁修行しなさいって言ってるくらいですもの。まさか歌手になりたいなんて言い出せなくって。
Looks like the CP team got inspiration from that, too. Overall, watch Penguin's Memory. It's a Club Penguin anime movie meets war, meets beer, meets romance, which seems like the weirdest combination ever, but it works far better than I really thought. Although the movie is obscure and I don't really see anybody talking about it, it was well worth a watch for the story and the aesthetics alone. Also, Chico the bird is amazing too. Do-do-do, Club Penguin anime, pretty cool, do-do-do. Oh, what? You guys are still here? You do know that the video is over, right? Well, now that you still want to watch, I guess I can go over a conspiracy theory that I have about Penguin's Memory. So at the very end of the movie, spoiler alert, there's a scene where Mike comes to the fork in the road between the two destinations he's really been wanting to visit. He's walking on the road without knowing which way to take, and then Jill comes along in her car to pick him up. This is very similar to that one scene in the Steins Gate episode where they travel to America. Combine that with the fact that the entire movie is very similar to Club Penguin, and now I can form my incredible conspiracy theory. Someone who grew up around this time who knew about Club Penguin and Steins Gate, two things I love, will at some point in the future go back in time to the 80s. They will create this movie featuring both of these things, and make it so obscure that I will not find out about it until after I began liking anime, which was only last year. That's why I found out about this movie's existence very recently. It all adds up. There's some sort of message about a future war hidden in here or something, and I gotta find it. Alright, that's enough. Crazy Veil Skibum out. But anyway, that's all for this video. Subscribe for more awesome cartoon videos. Give a thumbs up and comment below, let me know what you think. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.